driving in your car. The lights ahead of you. The lights behind you.
You're driving in your car?
They're blurring together.
I've never heard this version.
There's a large light at the end of the road. It's glowing yellow.
It's come a lot.
It's starting to take shape. You can see it now. The light. It's becoming clearer and clearer. It is What the Podcast.
God. What the Podcast Heaven.
Well, actually,
welcome into the light.
Welcome. Pick up your harp and your halo at the door.
And your microphone, of course.
Of course. Welcome back to What the Podcast. I'm Ryan.
I'm John.
And together we are
Ryan and John.
On the couch as always, producer Cara Tafoya. And this week we've got a special guest in the studio. Can I call you the founder?
Yeah.
The creator, the...
You can make up a title, you know, for
the
me.
The penultimate person behind the Visible magazine. Yes, and now the host of the Visible Podcast.
That's me.
Sammy Noel is here in the studio.
Ooh. Yeah. Ooh.
Big hand for
her. Hi, guys. Thank
you. How are you doing today?
Thank you. I'm doing pretty good. I got a massage this morning.
Wow.
Jealous.
Oh. It was great.
We got to keep things loose. You know, we got a big weekend.
Literally. Actually, the massage therapist, when I left, she literally looked at me and said, "Oh, do you feel soft?"
I was like, and you said, yes.
I said, yeah.
Do you feel soft? I think that's a question for her, right? I mean, do I feel soft? Yes.
How do you know?
Also,
that's her way of saying relaxed.
Let me say that intro gave me Perks of Being a Wallflower vibes. Oh. You know, when he's like in the car
through the tunnel.
Yep. Tunnel.
Yeah.
Do you ever see that movie, John?
Yeah, I watched it with you, I think.
It's a great flick. Take me right back.
I still feel like I've never watched it fully through.
Okay.
You say that about every movie we've talked about. Pretty much, to be fair.
All of my favorite movies. I'm like, every time movie will change my
life. I've seen it all the way through.
Okay,
and
I've seen
what?
Like the first 10 minutes
to be
of
fair,
it.
I go to his parents' house. We start a movie.
Okay.
And everyone is asleep like 45 minutes in.
Mm-hmm.
And then he's like,
too?
All right, let's go home.
Is that
no,
you
me.
Too?
I'm awake. And then he's like, all right, let's go home.
We watch
and there's
a lot
like 20
of
minutes left
home,
of the movie.
Hey. But I'm just saying, it's just funny that every time we bring up a movie, you always go, I don't think I've seen the whole thing. And I'm thinking, how many
That's
partial
why.
Movies
I
have you seen?
I think it's okay to not remember the whole thing.
No.
It's okay.
I've watched Top Gun 3 times at your parents' house, and we always finish.
At the same spot.
At the same spot.
Let me tell you about Perks of Being a Wallflower. When that movie came out, it felt like somebody finally got me, you know? Like,
did you not
read
like?
Stupid
you didn't
eighth
read the book?
Grader was
wow.
like... I feel
this is deep.
Infinite. Like, I was that kid on the truck in the tunnel for some time.
And then I read. Were you trying to be
So
that
I
kid?
Read the book.
Oh, okay. Gosh.
Oh, whoa.
Sorry.
Yikes. No, I was. No, of course. It's a vicious cycle. So I read the book. A lot sadder than the movie.
Really?
Pretty sad. So, like Sammy, glad you're here this week.
yeah, good
I was
here.
Like, welcome
good
back here. To What the
welcome
Therapy.
Back. What the, that's pretty
probably
much,
the name of
yeah,
this.
For the listeners yeah. and the viewers, they know. I mean, come on. It's pretty much every week.
That's true.
And we don't have the lovely Annie Scobin with us this week, but
sad.
She'd be unpacking all of this right now.
That's
but.
True.
Let's unpack that.
She really
let's,
would.
Let's not, you know?
Or she'd
not.
Have some traumatic experience of her own that she'd be sharing
yeah,
right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, she's always got a one-up.
She
up
always
us.
Comes up with some story. I'm like, wait, what? Where did you grow up?
She's lived so
she's
much
like,
life.
I killed my twin in the womb.
And I'm like, whoa, all right.
In Alpine.
In Alpine.
In Alpine.
She did. She probably didn't do that. Sammy, let's talk Visible.
Okay.
For the listeners and the viewers that might not know what we're talking about, describe yes. to us Visible. What is Visible?
All right. Visible Magazine is a magazine.
It's not,
I just left
and
that.
Let's pause there for a second because it's not all the time that you, like, at least these days, like, print media
yeah.
is not, like, the forerunner of anything, really.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I've always had a huge appreciation for, like, the physical, like, feel of a magazine. Sure. Especially, you know, those, like, really beautiful curated ones that take... I mean, you listen to the Visible podcast, right?
I do.
Did you listen to the part... Or did you hear the part where I was talking about how I really love, like, Kinfolk and I love Darling, like, magazine?
Describe it to me, because... I did, but wow. I'd love to hear you tell me again.
That's fan. Really convincing.
Yes, big fan, big fan. No, no, I know what you're talking about. But for,
but
everybody,
for
else,
everyone else. Right. Well, okay, so back to Visible Magazine is a magazine that started back in October mm-hmm. of 2021, so last year. But it was something that kind of was on my heart and mind for like 5 years mm-hmm. before it actually became reality. And the whole point of the magazine is to highlight people. We kind of use the term that we made up called rehumanizing mm-hmm. San Diego. And it's based off of this thought I did have like years ago about we pass so many people every single day, whether mm-hmm. it's on the freeway, like on the 805, you know, you're driving yep. past the same people at the same time every day. Or you go to the same coffee shop, like however many times a week, right? What do you really know about the person who's serving you coffee? Or what do you know about the people you're passing by? Do you actually know their story and who they are? So the magazine's intent is to highlight human beings.
Yes.
A lot of the time, a lot of the segments are introducing them through a craft or a title that they have and mm-hmm. breaking it down to kind of their life story.
Sure.
Mm. Yeah.
I really liked, I think it's in the first issue, the very first issue, because now... Spoiler alert, today being Friday, issue number 3 comes out.
Woo!
That's so exciting.
So exciting.
I'm so excited to have the third one on my coffee table.
Whoa. That's true. We're big fans of the magazine.
Yeah.
It's issue number 1. It's the very first one I got to mm-hmm. read, and it's a story about, I'm going to forget the fellow's name, but it's just a guy.
Yes, Troy.
Troy.
Troy's his
name.
And
it's just a story about Troy, and he... is walking through his old neighborhood and you guys mm-hmm. are interviewing him, I'm assuming. And he's just talking about like, oh, I used to live over here and I knew the mom at this house. And yeah. oh, when my parents would fight, I'd go over there and like, we'd all, you know, meet up at night and then like, or we'd play outside until the streetlights came on, basically
yeah.
that kind of story. And it's just super compelling. Cause like you said, like, I wouldn't think twice about Troy maybe,
right?
You know, but everybody knows a Troy and everybody,
yeah.
you know,
yeah. Well, plus San Diego, especially if you guys have lived here for
yes.
ever, mm-hmm. but it's really as big of a city as it is. It's really a big city of small towns.
Yep.
So everyone knows everyone.
It's true.
Do you know what I mean?
So
like your
bizarre.
Family.
Oh yeah.
Insanely connected to 5 million different realms of
yes.
people, right?
Totally.
Like all throughout mm-hmm. San Diego. It's crazy.
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah.
Especially like, you know, the church world, ministry world, mm-hmm.
yeah.
the theater world, all of it like intersects. And, you know, it's like,
true.
I know this person because their kid was on this baseball team and what, like, you know, it all
right.
is very visible.
Whoa.
Did it work?
That's deep.
No,
it's close.
I'm going to try.
You're trying.
Get
I'll sustain
it.
It
as much as
I'll
I can.
Sustain
thank
it.
You. Thank you.
Yeah.
Objection.
Our favorite thing.
Objection
hearsay.
Thank you. I've been
objection.
Watching the Amber Heard trial.
Me
a lot,
too.
So.
I literally, this week especially, since Amber was on the stand, I was like,
man.
Oh.
The clips have gone up and that from that trial,
yeah.
dude. Anyway, sorry.
They did not do her any favors.
No, no.
Those
no.
lawyers,
nope.
man.
She's a savage.
It's pretty rough.
Oh my gosh.
Pretty rough. But that's not what we're here for. We're not here for that. We'll get
maybe
to
maybe
that.
Later.
Maybe a little later.
Bit into that.
But yeah, so I guess my question for you is like, what's the most exciting? Like, what you've interviewed these people, you've gotten to take pictures of them.
Yeah.
What's some of your favorite bits that have come out of the first 3 issues?
What's cool is the first issue was essentially made, all of the features were made up of friends, like my friends mm-hmm. or friends of people who are on the team, which we have a 4-person team right now. But what's been really cool is like everyone is so hyped on what this is, which honestly I wasn't expecting.
Yeah.
Okay, so for a lot of my life, I...
It's all right.
Wow.
What comparison? It's embarrassing.
Should we take a moment of silence for that?
Wow.
No. Keep going. You got it.
Oh. Worst things have happened on this podcast. I'll say
yeah. Yep.
I want an episode of just what you've edited out.
Oh, there's...
There's not much, honestly.
It's a...
Well,
in the beginning, there's a lot. In the beginning, there's a lot.
First 25 episodes, there's quite a bit.
We started this, I'd never been on a podcast before.
Yeah.
And so you just... When you start doing, like... brain to mouth to microphone.
Oh,
that's danger.
Yeah. But
also, Olivia fine. Was here.
Yeah. Thank you. If Olivia's watching, she's really right. saved us.
And let me tell
you. In the beginning, you could just tell by a look. You're like, that's getting cut out. Because at
I'll
the end,
what, that's not. She's not listening.
No, because at the end, Olivia goes, you should cut this out. And we're like, Ryan and I are like total older brothers. We're like, no, I stand by
it. I meant.
I stand by it. And then she goes, I'm going to probably leave if you don't cut it out. I'm like, all right, fine, we'll cut it out. And we cut it out.
Wow, that's the sound of us ripping down the curtain.
Yeah, it's true.
Fully, wow. Exposing ourselves to the world.
Oh, yeah.
Exposed.
Yeah. Huh. Cut that out.
If you don't think, if you think we've survived 78 episodes without cutting some things out, you know, it just happens.
Look, it's just straight up. It's real. Okay, it's raw. Mm. And just like
and
visible.
What we cut out, it isn't it's not like bad stuff. It's just like
life,
things we
man.
Said. That maybe could be construed in a different way.
Yeah. No, that's fine.
It wasn't malice intent.
No.
Oh, I would not expect that.
All right, whatever. You know what? I'll send you all the cutouts.
I'm telling you, Sammy appreciates the raw, unfiltered. Look.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a little bit of filtering, I'm sure. Invisible, but...
Oh, yeah, I imagine, right? You filter some of that stuff?
Yeah, a lot of... especially with transcribing...
Okay. So
you cut out so many, like, even just that is literally, well, and I even do that with, we're three episodes in on the Visible podcast, and
sure.
I've cut so many likes or
yes.
butts.
Sure.
Or
shores.
Cut that out.
Sure. I will say, I'll back up a little bit too. Yeah. Sammy's here with us today because what the podcast is featured.
It's true.
In volume issue number 3.
Very honored.
That's
of Visible.
What's up?
Big write up. Big, you know,
it was
we got
great.
To take some photos out in San Diego. We got
yes.
to, and I think my favorite part of this whole thing is we got to sit down at dinner.
Wow.
Okay, go ahead.
And we just got to chat with Sammy and the four of us, or the five of us sat together, the four of us on the podcast got to sit with Sammy, and it was just chaos. Absolute nonsense.
It was chaos.
And somehow you got to took all of that, which you just recorded our conversation, and forged it into this beautiful write-up that actually made us sound like we've got a system going here.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I know.
It's
reading it and going
special.
And like, wow. I mean, and also it's fun to talk, to do an interview like that because it allows us to kind of relive what we've kind of been through on the podcast.
Yeah.
You know, because we've been doing this for now 78 episodes and we've over a year nonstop every week. And so you kind of go back there and you're like thinking about all those times. So it was really fun in that sense. I was telling you guys in the group message that I got a kind of a little bit emotional reading it. Cause I was like, oh yeah. Like, you know, just hearing all of us talk about it and just kind of reflecting, it was so cool. So yeah, it was a great experience for me at least.
Oh,
such
so
a fun time.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was
you
a blast.
Made it sound funny.
I think
there were some parts
that
I was
us.
Like, oh, that was funny.
That was us. I think we were just.
I think you guys are just funny.
Maybe we were just the funny all along.
Yeah. Maybe the funny was there. The
real
whole time.
Visible was the friends we made along the way.
Oh,
please,
friend.
Please. I can't.
You can print that.
I can't.
If you want to do a last minute edit.
Yeah. Let me just. I'll write it in.
Oh, yeah.
I'll write it in Sharpie at the bottom of your
thank you.
Yeah.
Tell me more. What other kind of like people have you interviewed? You've gotten to. You take all the pictures you, I'm assuming, are on the front end of all of the interviews and everything.
Yeah. So I kind of head everything up, which I have an incredible group of people who I get to do it all with. But I do all the photography. I do currently like the full design of, and like piecing together of the magazine.
Ooh, that must be fun.
It is fun. It's very fun. It's very like, it's cool to see even just three issues in now, the how much it's gotten better. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Yes. Not just because of like, oh, I know what I want to do with it now, but also because I'm like, oh, like there's more time. Like mm-hmm. literally mm-hmm. the first issue I was working up to the like the launch time yeah. and then uploading.
Yeah.
And I was like, but specifically that sound was what I mean.
I love that.
But as far as interviewing like types of people that we interview is obviously anyone and everyone, but we kind of have some pretty consistent segments. Like every issue we interview a couple, which mm-hmm. is really exciting because Ashley and Josh Henson, who you know, are the couple for this issue.
I do know them.
Yeah.
They're some of my coworkers.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, she, wow. Ashley posted about us on Instagram.
She did.
Wow.
About the show.
So sweet.
About us.
Whoa.
Which is, you guys are the show. The show is you.
Well,
so. We were just talking about that earlier.
Well, the podcast with Ryan and John so. Is... Technically, the name. Of
yeah,
this
shut up.
Situation.
Is that what it's, wait, that's not what it's listed as, yes. though, on Spotify, yeah,
that's
is it?
That's for branding. That's,
no, yeah. it's just.
What the podcast?
All the.
Just don't yeah. forget the little. Can we cut to.
Yeah,
to
just
this?
Sharpie go my ahead. Name in there.
Zoom no. that in there.
You're going to cut to the snow. Yeah. Sharpie my name in there.
That's great.
Sharpie my name in there.
Well, she does do quite a bit.
Sorry, it's in black Sharpie, though.
Okay, yeah. You see that?
It is there, but you just can't see it.
Oh, my gosh.
I always wonder about the team. I don't know if you want to share a little about your team, because that's one of my favorite projects about creative projects is the team.
Yeah.
And it's always more fun to do it like something creative with people, I think, than like having the pressure of doing it alone. I know you talked about, you know, this has gotten easier over time. And I wonder if that is confidence because of your team or just confidence because of experience. Who's on your team? Tell
so
us.
We have a team of four. We have me. And then we also have Sabrina, who mm-hmm. was at your guys. Actually, the whole team was at your photo shoot.
Okay.
So Sabrina, she handles like social media management and communication. So she is shooting out the text and like reaching out to like certain people about whatever to make things happen kind of thing, as well as posting on social media for us.
Yeah, I saw her filming the whole time during our photo shoot.
She gets the content, baby. Yes. That's what she does.
Classic.
Yeah. And then we have Mita, and she's our stylist. So she has her own segment in the issue.
Yes.
Every issue called Trending in SD. And it's very fashion focused. She chooses a neighborhood of San Diego.
She's so good.
She's so good.
Gosh.
Every time I'm like, I literally, so how I asked her to be involved with Visible was we both work at a church together. She's like an impact coordinator at her church, but we were at a going away party for a coworker, and I walked up to her afterwards and I was like, would you want to maybe style for a fashion segment in this magazine that I'm starting? This is what it is. This is what it's called. And she was like, huh? And I was like, you just like look cool no matter what you're wearing, and you make other people look cool. Wow. And I don't even get it. So I just feel like you'd be really good at it. And Zeb, it was something she wanted to do forever.
The rest is history. Wow. Now she's the stylist.
She's the stylist. Yeah. But we also kind of, we connect her with our features and all of that. If they are interested in kind of having someone help them feel really confident in what they're
wearing.
You're
starting to say the fashion segments focus on a neighborhood of San Diego?
Uh-huh. Yeah, so the fashion segment, each issue has a different neighborhood that she focuses in on and styles around in San Diego.
Wow.
Which is really cool. And it was all her idea.
Yeah.
She was like, I just feel like it'd be really cool because in order to showcase San Diego style, there's so many different spots and... like aesthetics and environments in San Diego that it would make sense to focus in on one area and style around that. So this one is Hillcrest what she's styling around, which is, that one was so fun.
Nice.
It's cool.
Right in time for San Diego Pride. That's perfect.
Yep.
That's true.
Just set it up, teen it up.
Mm-hmm. And is that member number four? That was, you've got
one,
you.
Two, yes. Three. And then we also have our lead writer. Okay. Her name is Dez. She kind of showed up like halfway through your guys' shoot.
Yes.
She's actually the newest member to the team. So our first lead writer, his name is Chris. He's with us for the first two issues. And then he's now become, he stepped more into a featured writer role.
Okay.
As opposed to like a part of the core team. But Dez is kind of going to start like, she like is taking charge on the writing front type of thing. And we'll probably have featured, we plan on having featured writers throughout, but she'll kind of be heading up that area.
Do you
area.
Have any part of the writing or are you?
So the process is like, as far as all of the writing goes, is I have the writers upload their articles as soon as they're done. I then have a team of proofreaders go in and proofread everything, like comment, suggest everything that could possibly be like added or taken away to better communicate, right? And then from there, after everyone's made their comments, I go in and I proofread everything and I go through everyone's comments. And then for certain things, for this issue, which this is the first issue I've done this, but I've taken on a little bit of writing. So I wrote your guys.
Right.
Yeah, which a lot of yours was transcribing, but it was more like commentating on just conversation.
No, it was written really well.
Thanks. I really enjoy writing, but I don't think I would ever, like, as of right now, I'm like, I'm not a writer, but I love writing and facets like that, like storytelling and
so
stuff like that.
When you were coming up with the idea for this magazine, did you always see yourself as, like, the curator of it all? Or were you like, I would love to just take photos, I would love to, how did that kind of...
I love content curation.
Yeah.
I'm so passionate about like how things look all together as a, like a cohesive unit. It's honestly one of the reasons I really do love social media, that side of social media at least, because I like making things look like very aesthetically pleasing. And so I think with, and intentional, and I think where the magazine comes in, it's like, I've always had an interest in photojournalism.
Yes.
And so getting to pair, you know, the personality and story that comes through photos with written word is really cool. So I kind of always wanted to be the curator. I think depending on how, you know, Visible grows and what it looks like a few years from now, I probably won't be doing that, but I'd love to be, you know, like kind of like the final say of like, and kind of setting the tone of what it could look like, if that makes sense.
Did you ever do anything like this in the past? Like any kind of project like that, where you're bringing a lot of different creative things together or even just making any kind of like creative projects?
That is such a good question.
Hey.
Awesome.
7-8 episodes later.
Oh my gosh.
You were doing that episode.
I'm good at
curating.
Can't
give you episode one.
Curating questions.
Episode two, it was great though.
Question curator. Okay. That should be your title.
Thank you. It technically is. It's written in Sharpie right here.
On the TV. Just wait till you change it. Sharpie, yeah, right. So you can see it right
you
now.
See it right
you
now.
Actually wrote on the TV. Turn it off.
Imagine. That is such a good question.
It kind of like the whole concept harkens back to like, I feel like when I was in high school, it was like zines.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like the skate zine.
Totally.
Like, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
the zine?
You
ever know a zine, John? Anybody make zines over at the...
That was not an East County thing.
No, it wasn't.
I'm going to say that right now.
I did hear about it, though.
I had never heard of a zine until we went to Hawaii.
That's a bummer.
On our honeymoon and saw like free ones. And I was like,
that's when
like,
you first
hey,
heard
zines.
About a zine?
And
no,
I was like,
no zines over
zine?
At a...
magazine?
What school did you go to?
Oh, we had a school magazine, sure, but it wasn't like
zines are like
anything
more
to
like
write home
mini,
about, you know,
underground,
like mini magazine, like independent.
They had one at my sister's school, and it was called the Rambler.
And it was like, I remember that.
The Rambler,
yeah,
and it was like just weird little articles and art, like people would like do poetry and
kind of just sounds like a school's magazine.
But it wasn't through the school because that would make it lame. Like the whole zine culture is like kids coming together.
Yeah.
And it's like it started in like the 80s, basically the whole punk scene, like making these little zines.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Cool.
No, I know exactly.
It's reminiscent
of that.
It's very surf skate culture.
It's,
I feel like
it's cool because like you said, like San Diego is so small, but it's also big. Like there's so much in San Diego too. And it really is cool to like you get little pieces of that throughout the whole issue.
That's cool. That's really cool to hear. Uh-huh. That makes me happy. Yeah. And it's cool too, because like, I feel like we have so many different kinds of people in one issue, which is really exciting, because like, we have you guys, a podcast team crew family.
That'll do.
That'll work. That's
us. Team crew family.
Well, that's crew fam. Pretty accurate, actually.
Yeah. And then, like, you know, a few pages later, we have a florist, like a sustainable florist that we interviewed. Wow. Like, stuff like that, where I'm like...
I will say, being able to say that I was being interviewed for a magazine was like the coolest thing I think I've said this
That's
year.
What a lot of people have said.
Like we were going to go to dinner with my wife's grandparents, and they're like, "Oh, you're for dinner?" And I was like, "Ooh, I have an interview for a magazine tonight." And they're like, "What?" And I'm like, "Yeah, it's no big deal."
It's an air of whoa.
It's gone down.
It's fine. Don't draw attention to it.
I was just so okay. I'm
just
gonna
say.
No, please pick up your water.
I'm just gonna leave it.
You can have your water.
It lives there now.
So that was really cool.
It's an air of like legitimacy, you know?
Yeah, and then telling my family like, "Oh, you know, there's a release party, release dinner that is happening," and I was like, "Oh, I can't do that because I'll be at the magazine release." And they're like, "You're in a magazine?" And I was like, "Yeah, with the podcast." And they're like, "What?"
And oh,
like,
yeah, that's our podcast was on.
Our podcast.
It's so funny because I feel like it's that thing of like the skipping generations, where like the older generation is like magazines, and then the younger generation is like magazines, but then the middle they're like magazine.
It's the digital thing when we went analog to digital. Mm-hmm.
It's like now, like, oh, I just came out with my album's on vinyl, and it's like, yeah, oh,
there's
that's so
there's
cool.
bands releasing to cassette these days.
Oh, like, what?
I'm pretty sure the Frights put out their last album.
They go to like Urban Outfitters. Like,
yeah, oh my gosh,
like on cassette. And it's like,
it's cool though.
We talk about it.
It's pretty cool though. Right?
That's so cool.
No, it's awesome. Like, not a shred of irony there. I think
you guys should release the podcast only on.
Oh my gosh.
On wax cylinder.
That would be cool. On vinyl.
Yeah.
We should do our weekly podcast on vinyl
every
week. And you mail it to people.
We mail it out.
They sign up for a mailing list.
Hold on.
Whoa.
That actually could be kind of cool for like Patreon. Special occasion. Hey, you should do something.
We would need a lot of vinyls for over an hour.
A limited run. No, it's just real slow. And it's like, you know how you get like a book on tape, you know, like,
you're listening that's true. To what
the but then you have oh my gosh, it. I love that.
To hear the rest of the story.
Flip.
Rewind and bring back to your local library. We just get tapes at the library. Like,
oh my
how
gosh.
Stupid.
Never again.
It's coming back though, apparently.
Really?
Libraries?
Oh, of course. Classic. Of course.
They've always been there.
People want to just hang out at the library. It's like,
whatever.
It's go home. Go home. Okay.
Right. Go listen to your wax cylinder at home.
Did you guys know that to be a librarian, you need to have a master's in...
Organizational studies.
Books.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wait. I didn't know that. How did you know that?
Pulled that out of my
You did. You did. Did
my
you?
Dad got a BA in organizational studies.
Oh my gosh.
Was he going for his master? Did he want to be a librarian?
No, no. He was in the police
that's
department,
a good
and
question.
The only way to like break the next pay grade was to have a degree. It could be in anything.
Sure.
And so
he
went back to school for organizational studies,
underwater
which, by the way,
weaving.
His college doesn't recognize as a degree anymore.
Well,
but
anymore.
He has one.
What does organizational studies mean?
So
like, what do you do?
I thought it was like organizing stuff. Like, I thought,
yeah,
like,
that's what I think.
I thought, like, my dad could organize a meme.
He's got
door,
a master's
right?
In the Dewey Decimal System.
Oh my
but
gosh.
I think after more investigation, I realized that it's like an organization, like how to structure, like a healthcare organization, how to structure that and management. It's more management.
That makes so much
because
more sense.
I thought it was like, what, can you organize a drawer?
Or really? You go to the container store?
You can make a Word document.
I gave him so much crap about it. And
he's
then I realized
really
I was like,
Excel.
But I will say, I think there was a class in there about how to organize things because my dad organized things in the weirdest way. Like, it's super efficient, but I would never think about it. And I think it's because of his degree.
That's that Dewey Decimal System.
Yeah,
bro.
Yeah.
Makes no sense.
No proof, but,
you know, measure the books by color or whatever.
So his degree also doesn't have the name of his degree on it. It's just like his college,
just
and it says
bachelor's.
Like bachelor's to Dan Albright or whatever, you know, the whole thing. And it doesn't actually say the name of his degree. So he's like, I'm not even sure this is a real thing, but
I thought about you this week. You know who got a doctorate?
Who?
Taylor Swift.
Oh, God.
from NYU.
Stop. Don't just don't say anything.
So stupid. Just, so stupid. Just let it, you know, okay, you know just it's stupid, let it though. Be.
Can I just say one thing about that? Because
yeah, let's hear it.
The way I saw it, it was extremely misleading. Yeah. I was like, has Taylor Swift been going to NYU for the past, like, whatever
No, years? They just gave it to her.
And then I saw honorary doctorate. Yeah, no, because I saw her reel about, like, wearing a cap and gown for the first time ever.
I was like, weird. What? Ever. When she was like, ever,
yeah, because
like,
she, like, started so
thing.
Young.
That's a thing
so,
they
like,
do,
yeah.
You know? They just give out
Taylor Swift
honorary. It's not a doctorate, but they had her do the... What
the
do you
graduation
call it?
Speech.
Yeah, the commencement.
Whoever does the commencement speech.
And all she did was read out her song lyrics. She's like, she's like, welcome to New York. It's been waiting for you. That was it.
Wait, are you serious? I didn't watch it.
She goes, welcome to New York.
Okay, we literally
it's
watched 2 minutes
for
of
you.
It, and she did that, and he was like, nope, no more.
Okay.
No, no, I refuse to watch it.
My belief in the college system is
we pay all this money. You have to pay it all back. And also, Taylor Swift is doing your commencement speech.
She even said, she's like, I'm not
a
doctor.
That would have made it worth it for me.
She goes, I'm not a doctor of anything serious, but if you need somebody to sing a song for you,
they're like, yeah, you're so brave.
And it was like Yankee Stadium.
You're so brave.
I know. I saw like
NYU
one TikTok about it.
Massive school. There's probably tens of thousands of people there.
That is kind of the worst news I've ever seen.
How do they pick someone? Because like my brother graduated.
She did a... I think she was a guest in a class, and she actually did like a speech.
Kill me. Oh, really?
So I think
she
like
just did the commencement.
I just don't know because my brother graduated from USC with his bachelor's, and Will Ferrell did the commencement.
Yeah,
there
is it. People who've gone there sometimes.
Sometimes it is like I know they gave Conan O'Brien one because he dropped out of Harvard, but then came back and did a commencement, and so they. Give
okay.
him an honorary.
So they were
degree.
Like, you kind of.
That's
kind of
funny.
It means nothing but like for fun.
He's like,
you know?
I kind of went here.
Yeah, exactly.
In his Conan style.
Murder me.
You gonna just stew on that one a little bit?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it is what it is.
You could do it.
Yeah, well, sure.
Hey, when the podcast takes off.
When it takes off, we'll both do it together.
Oh.
Just out there.
Oh my gosh.
I don't think anyone would
And I'll get
happen.
Up on the stage and go, welcome to the podcast.
I'm
Ryan.
I'm John. Everyone will scream.
They're Ryan and John.
At Petco Park.
Ryan and John.
So stupid.
Yeah.
What school? What'd you do that for?
Probably SDSU.
Probably Grossmont.
Grossmont. I will only accept.
Got him.
I will only accept. I went there for 5 years. Hmm? And never graduated.
I know.
Oh, I was literally going to be like, what'd you major in? What did you major in?
Organizational
studies.
I'm five
She's
credits
understanding
away.
The podcast now.
I'm 5 credits away from an AA at Grossmont in communications.
No shame in the AA,
which basically
bro.
Means nothing, honestly.
What was it?
That's
one
fine,
more time. Communications?
Fine.
Communications, yeah.
You're communicating.
Look at this. I know, maybe I can get
also
an honorary
a degree in communications
in
gets you
communications.
Anywhere.
Yeah, what the podcast... right, EDU. You're can give I give you some credits?
Can I get some credits? Yeah, no, that would be great. No, yeah,
I'll talk to some people.
Mm. I'd love to get a speech at Grossmont. It's the perfect setting. I mean,
gosh,
I've seen graduation there. By the way, it is
great time.
Just awesome.
Well, half the time people don't go.
Well, I would.
Those poor souls. I know you would.
I hope you'd be there.
Hey, 5 credits away.
I hope you'd
be
there. In the back. Cheering me on. The cap and gown is probably not even worth the money I would pay for it, but I'd do it anyway.
I'll pay for it for you, bro. If you're hurting for money,
thank you.
I got it.
Classes
that.
Are steep now.
That's
there goes my
money. Well, Sammy, so speaking of podcasts,
yes,
let's talk about yours.
Okay.
Rival podcast.
Whoa.
She's a rival.
You had
now.
Mentioned at our interview, you're like, I think we're going to start one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then it happened.
And then it happened.
That's how it happened.
We did it. Yeah.
How's it feel?
Great. I've always wanted to do a podcast. That's mm-hmm. also just something that I love podcasts.
Yes.
I'm a big podcast
What's
fan.
Your top podcast right now?
Good.
Okay.
Not of all time, maybe, but what are you listening to right now?
I have a few different ones. I just recently finished, I really love journalism podcasts.
Mm-hmm.
So like the ones that Serial has put out.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you know,
Good
have
stuff.
You heard of S-Town?
No, mm-hmm. I'm not familiar.
No? Okay.
John is.
Yeah, and then they just released one back in February called The Trojan Horse Project, which, fascinating. But also, I get really upset with journalism podcasts sometimes when they don't, like, when nothing, they just give up at the end. Like, where it doesn't. So if that's going to frustrate you, don't listen to it because I'm just smashing this. Like, sorry, I'm slamming a podcast right now on a podcast.
As long as it's not our podcast.
I'm listening to podcasts that don't end well. So if you like that.
No, I appreciate the honesty. I really do. I mean, you know,
sorry.
There's something to that, though. I mean, you know, journalism doesn't always end well.
No, it's, I mean, it's so real, but I also was like, you just like gave up on it. And it was so interesting and fascinating. Mm. Anyway, that's one thing I was listening to. And I just recently finished. I listened to you guys pretty regularly, well, honestly.
All right, thanks.
Seriously. No, it's like so nice because I have, on the days I work at the church, I have like a very long commute. So like podcasts are my choice of content.
Yes.
And it's like you guys, like if I'm not hitting traffic, it's like the perfect amount of time. To listen to like the first half.
That's a serious commute. And okay, the first half. Finish it up.
And then I listen to some lifestyle podcasts. One of them is called Note to Self by Peyton Sarton.
Okay.
I think those are like the main ones.
How are you on the top of hearing your own voice recorded?
You know, I actually hate it. A lot less than I was like, let me pause.
Everyone thinks it's as worse as it actually is.
I hate it a lot less than I used to hate it. Mm-hmm. I don't love my talking voice.
Sure.
Go away, fly.
It's a fly in here. Gosh. I think he's a fly. He's been around here for a while.
Summer has
Okay,
sprung.
Well, I'm out. No, I'm just kidding.
Here at Santee.
Summer's around.
Summer's here.
That's our staffing guy. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
It's our doorman.
He's looking for you. He has some porn for you to sign.
He's here for, he'll be back. He's from Grossmont. He's here for credits. Here. College credits.
Yeah.
He
I totally
life.
Get that. Intern. Intern.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
Intern. Unpaid.
Unpaid
also,
intern.
Unpaid, you know.
Yeah.
I was the same way. We started this and I hated it. I was like, I can't even listen to this back.
Really?
And I've gotten past it.
Yeah, you listen to
that,
it all
like,
the time.
Shocks
now I love
me.
It.
You re-listen to the
episodes. Now I look for clips. I look for, but that first couple of, I want to say even like the first 10 episodes,
I was like,
oof.
I listen to it and I watch it and I'm like, I don't sound like that.
You have a great time.
That's not me.
You just are like, no, I refuse to accept that.
I've been doing podcasting for a little while.
Yeah.
And in the beginning,
you have such a nice voice though.
Thank you. Ryan and I get that a lot actually. When we're on Growing Pains, which is Annie's podcast.
Yes.
Annie's mom always will text her and be like, Ryan and John just sound so great. Like,
yeah,
and she's
you guys
like,
do
what
have
about
very...
me, mom? But I, in the beginning, I loved what I love about podcasting is having the headphones on and like being like lost in the interview. Like, I don't know if you've gotten that yet on an episode, but like you almost like can hear people like really well. You just kind of get locked into the world. Mm-hmm. Annie and I always joke about that we're narcissists in the sense that like we could sit in this setting, not recording, and talk all day long.
Yeah.
Something about like
hearing your own voice in your ears.
Well, being able to hear each other really well and like being kind of locked into that, like it feels like a different world. And then you take the headphones off and you're like,
outside sound to distract you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I actually don't mind it anymore. I don't. I listen to this podcast back every once in a while, and I laugh at us. I don't know why. I think we're hilarious.
I literally laugh out loud sometimes.
It's pretty
so
rough.
Great.
Now I'm like, I'll laugh at my own jokes.
Dang
one
it.
Hit so good, Ryan.
Oh my gosh!
So funny.
You know what I was gonna do? I was gonna call you Diesel today.
Diesel.
Oh, stop.
Diesel.
I came in here prepared. I was like, oh my gosh, how funny would it be if I
hey,
like
up,
a little callback to last week?
She listens.
Better her than, because I fully dropped that bit. I should have.
Good.
No,
drop it.
Should have known.
I really wanted, I needed to
Dang
tell
it.
You that I had that. Intention, but
that,
I didn't do
you
it.
You really do listen to this podcast.
I'm not joking when I say I'm a fan of you
guys.
Well,
a lot of people would say that they listen to it. And
we'll post
go,
clips.
I don't know.
And people will be like, hey, I watched your podcast.
And like the like, 5 minutes.
They're like,
that
yeah.
That
and you're like, what part?
About?
What part?
TikTok? I'm like, yeah.
The show's actually an hour long.
When I listen to our episodes back, I'll do this thing where it's like someone will ask a question. And in my mind, I'm like, oh, this is my answer, but I don't remember saying that. And then I'll
you say
like, that's
you
what
always
I said.
In your mind say what you're about to say.
Yes,
because I rarely ever do.
How meta is it that you're going to be you might be listening to this bit about you listening.
And you'll be like, yeah, I didn't say the podcast.
And thinking about, because
like in the car,
I'll
be listening to it and be like, oh, haha, would have been funny if I said this. And then I actually say it. I'm like, I don't remember saying that.
I never say the stuff that I want to later.
I'm totally the one that in the shower, I'm just like taking, I'm like, oh, that would have been funny.
Oh, man.
That would have been a funny thing to say.
You're pretty quick, man.
It's a podcast of funny, apparently.
The one thing I want to say and ask you about is your interviewing skills, because you interviewed us, you know, for our piece in Visible Magazine, mm-hmm. and I was very impressed by like the questions you came up with. And as far as I can remember, you were not referencing anything prepared.
No,
you're a very good interviewer. Where do you think that came from? And how do you think you've grown in that in the last three issues, or maybe last year or so? I'm not sure.
No, thank you. That's a really big compliment. You know, I think that I've been trying for a while now to be a lot more intentional when I'm listening to people, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. Because I am definitely prone to be someone who is a reactor as opposed to a responder. But I feel like in interviews, it's so helpful to be, one, I try to take pressure off of myself and be like, this isn't an interview, this is a conversation, which is really helpful for me because then I'm not trying to like ask interesting questions and I can just ask what I'm actually thinking about. But yeah, I think also just like learning to listen fully and let it sink in, process it, and then be like, oh, okay, like where can we go from here? Because, and a lot of the time, from one answer to a question, it'll split into like five different questions. And I'm like, okay, like I really have to like pick which direction I want to go in and could these meet up later? You know, like that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But I think over the time span of like Visible, what's been cool to see is I feel like that perspective of viewing it as a conversation has become more natural, where I don't even need to like remind myself that anymore, which is really nice. Mm. I can just talk to people, which is the whole point of this anyway. It's like we're all people just talking about people and loving people. So, yeah, I think that's probably the best, like the most I've like seen.
Do you find it helpful that when you prepare for an interview, or are you kind of more like on the fly, like you kind of know in your head where you want to go with it, or do you have to kind of put pen to paper when you're prepping for something like this?
I think it depends. I think there's, for example, one segment I do like to have very specific like questions, like a rough like outline of what I would want to ask is the couple interview, because it's really based off that segment in general. It's called Mirrored Love, and it's based off of the concept that the more you are with your partner, like you start to take on things that reflect that person. Mm-hmm. And you also start to like realize more things you admire about them or admire about yourself and how you balance each other out. Mm-hmm. So with that being the whole heart and direction of that segment, I like to make sure that like there are very specific questions that kind of align with that thought process and mentality. Mm-hmm. And then naturally interviews just turn into conversational type of like interactions.
Yeah. So. No, you did great. You did great with us. You really let us kind of, you did a great job leading us too, because we're kind of a crazy bunch. Mm-hmm. And so you did a great job for like kind of leading the conversation.
We go down a lot of tangents.
We do.
And you brought us back. So I appreciate that.
Thanks. How about the photography? Do you see it the same way when you are going to go to a shoot?
Oh, that's interesting.
What kind of prep goes into that? Or are you like, hey, I'm just going to capture the moment? What does that look like for you?
I think one thing that's really helpful when it comes to, because my whole goal with the photography aspect of it is really to capture the essence of who a person is and mm-hmm. what their story is about mm-hmm. To the best that I can. And I think what's really helpful in that is actually the prep work of just talking to the other person or talking to the features or whatever mm-hmm. it may be, because I want them to know, hey, this isn't my agenda. Like, mm-hmm. it isn't about what I want this to look like. I want this to be fun for you. I want this to feel like you. I want you to be comfortable. And so when you, like texted me your idea, I was like, yes, like I can envision it, you know. Yes. I was like, I could see it, and that was really exciting. So I think with that, it's not a ton of prep work. It's more of a like making sure there's a moment of connection with that mm-hmm. person who's being the subject who's being photographed, in order to capture them to the best that I can.
That's a great way to look at it. I love that. And I think mm-hmm. you definitely do as Thanks. Far as everything I've seen.
Yes.
In the first two issues.
Yeah.
I want to know more about your photography background.
Oh,
let's hear it.
Yeah.
Trying to get the title, y'all. Okay.
Where did that like stem from? Because yeah, I always wondered. Because I was always there. Just like, oh yeah, Sammy the photographer.
I can tell you. Yearbook.
Really?
Yearbook. Okay. I was joking.
I in yearbook?
I don't know if you were. I was joking. Oh my God, because
just okay. me asking great. You about
this all coming down.
In another life, me and Sammy were fairly close. Like, oh, we really? Were like yeah. She dated my brother.
I did.
Oh. Gosh, really? I didn't know that.
She did, yeah.
Oh, you didn't? Yeah,
I don't,
yeah,
I don't
yeah.
mean to put you on the spot like that.
Oh,
but
no, I don't care.
The point is
I remember going to your house for a party, and you were sitting on the couch.
Wow.
Yeah, probably.
That probably checks out. That checks out.
Turns out.
Sorry, I didn't mean it like so. That.
I was just good like, friends yeah. with like anyone.
She does sit on. Because
I was like.
I'm sitting on a couch right now.
On the couch as always.
You also were in a band, I heard. Is that true?
Okay, back to the photography.
First
okay.
of all,
no. My point is that I have like very clear memories of Sammy, like always with a camera in her hand, like taking pictures and.
Oh really?
So actually, that's cool to hear. Yeah. I've really never asked you about like my pre-photography business.
I did mention life. The band, and I thought you were cool for that.
Yeah.
This band called At Least We Dream. And they,
oh my gosh.
And we are going to link them below.
Are they on YouTube? I wonder.
We do have
I feel like
one
we went
YouTube
to a
video.
Show at least
what? Epicenter. It doesn't yes. exist anymore. Yes. That was the that was the show that you were at, I think, is the one that's on YouTube.
At Least We What?
No way.
At I don't know.
Hey, At Least We Dream.
Honestly, okay, at least look up At Least We Dream. I'm just not going to, I'm trying to grow in this.
It's like
I'm trying to not be embarrassed
2010
about, like,
or something. Like,
don't be embarrassed. It's awesome.
2009.
Our like main one was Stranded back. Was the song that we like had on.
So
Stranded.
Good.
So
good.
Hardcore.
Whoa.
So hardcore.
Anyways, that's my memory of you. Is
that's
like
so
you being
funny.
In that band.
I found it. Uh-oh.
Oh, is okay, he playing it right now?
Oh, this is the thing
I
he
might.
Does.
Let's see. This is part I of might. The...
Oh my gosh.
Oh, here we go. Here we go.
Oh my gosh.
It's going to come through the sound bar, so you won't be able to hear it just for a second.
I'm just going to pop over my microphone.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Oh no. Oh, this was our promo. I thought it was going to be a different video. There's like a full performance of it.
Don't worry. Don't
oh my gosh,
worry.
The pixels.
Sorry. Hold on.
No, my you're bad. Good. Whoa, really?
My bad. I
let's get to
I found
the
it.
Video.
There's
I
like a
found
video
it.
That gets shown every.
Oh. This one.
So cool.
Oh my gosh.
I'm just going to scrub gosh. Through it real quick if that's right.
Yeah.
With you.
Just, yeah.
Oh, look at her. There she is. Whoa.
So cool.
You look so cool. Wait, hold on. Sam, you should not be embarrassed by this. This is awesome.
Bring it back.
Look at the part of you sing some of you. That's crazy. Old school lighting. Awesome!
Are you kidding me?
I'm sweating.
Ah, nice.
I feel like I'm in eighth grade again a little bit.
Oh my gosh.
Thank you for enduring that. I know that was difficult.
I had to go there. I'm sorry. It was like
it's okay.
hanging. She's like, how did you get your start in photography? And then I like saw it.
You were like,
I
listen.
Was there. I was there.
This
I
was her start in photography.
Like, you want to know?
You, by the way, awesome. Awesome. And you're a great
so
singer,
cool.
by the way.
Oh, thanks.
She is.
Oh,
she
my
is,
gosh.
Seriously.
Oh, my gosh. I can't. You know what's so funny is like that feels like a really another
like
life.
A lifetime ago. True.
Literally.
Yeah.
It's so insane.
Yeah.
When was that? Was that like
that was
your,
I think
like
I think I
would
literally
high school, like
was
junior?
It?
That was
in
10
junior high.
That was 10.
No,
that
I think.
Video was posted 10 years ago.
Yeah.
2012. Yeah, that checks out.
So you're senior?
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Or just graduated
school,
or something like that. Yeah.
You look really
wow.
cool.
Wow. Yeah.
So cool.
Oh my gosh.
Wow. Hey, listen, so, we have you on the show. We got to pull all the things out. You know,
listen. Like,
the podcast is an hour long. We're going to cover it all.
We're going to cover
there
it all.
There are so many friends of mine who are going to be so happy that you brought that up on the podcast.
We had to do it. My point is that's the answer to the question. It's a memory of that, and it's a memory of Sammy like taking pictures all the time.
Honestly, I love that.
But speak into that. I mean, don't let that be the answer.
I think that's it. He answered. Right,
cool.
I'm just kidding.
Cool.
Oh my gosh, that's funny. I really feel like I did just take photos all the time. Yeah. But
what was your first camera?
I think it was a Nikon D5100.
Nice. Okay, that's cool.
So. I have no idea
what that means.
Like, it was my first camera after like a Canon
a
point
Rebel
and shoot
T3.
Or something.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Cool
yeah.
pics.
Yeah, something like that. It's like a little silver
cool
thing.
Pics? Come on.
Oh my
gosh.
Comes out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A little bit.
So
yeah,
cool.
Totally. But yeah, I remember that whether it was with a camera or eventually an iPhone, it was like I was always taking photos of everything because. I don't know. I think I just like to document moments.
Posterity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's how it started. And I would always hear people being like, you have such a good eye and all of this stuff. And then I didn't start my photography business until 2017, which was kind of completely unintentional. I was working an office job for a mental health treatment center. Mm-hmm. I was doing insurance pre-authorizations.
Wow.
Yeah, it was
that's a different life.
Completely different life. Yeah. It was like an 8 to 5, 8 to 6 job where I was like in an office all day and I was doing work where I was like, "Oh, this is like really helping people, you know, and it's something I'm really passionate about," but it was draining to be in an office all day, every day. Like I had no energy for anything. And so after that, all I knew when I was leaving that job and like with the ins and outs of like school that I had kind of done, I knew I wanted to start a business. Like I wanted to do my own thing, be my own boss. And so, it kind of just happened that I got hired for a proposal shoot. And.
Well, that's a high pressure first shoot.
Right.
How was it?
It
did you get
went
any good
well.
Shots? Or?
Yeah. No, it went well. I was shocked. I was like, oh, maybe I can do this.
There's the resume right here.
Yeah. And it's like I'd done like little paid gigs before that. Like I did a couple things for like friends who had businesses or whatever. Mm-hmm. But it was like that was the first shoot I did where I wasn't also working another. Like I wasn't working a job and doing that or anything like that. So,
whoa.
Yeah. So that was like my first real gig. And over the years, it's kind of just developed. I've gone through a lot of waves of different photography realms I've been in. I kind of started in, honestly, you take whatever you get when you first start out, right? Mm-hmm. But I like wanted to kind of focus on branding, I think, because I'm really passionate about branding. But then I kind of moved more into weddings and couples and families. And now I have kind of pushed into this interesting combination of both. I do weddings and I also do a lot of branding gigs. Yeah. And
interesting.
Yeah. So
what's your favorite type of photography?
I really love, I love branding. Like
oh,
I love working with,
what does that mean? Like,
yeah. So I love working with, whether it be like essentially entrepreneurs or like business owners or, public personalities type of thing. Like I really love working with people who are trying to either tell a story with something they're selling or something that they're or a service they're offering. Mm-hmm. And I like being able to get creative with people in that way. And I think I really love getting the time to get to know someone before I capture that, you know, before like we create something.
understanding before you even pick up a camera, like understanding their essence and trying to capture that. I totally dig that.
Makes a lot of sense how you started this magazine. You've been interested in that since the beginning.
Yeah.
It's good.
So cool. Yeah. For 5 years, you've been stewing on this idea.
Yeah, I know.
So cool.
I know. It's cool. I like, it was one of those things where after a while, I had the thought of what, like, obviously this is something I want to do or else I wouldn't still be thinking about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But was there something that, like, I know you told us about how you kind of got it started and you'd been dreaming about it for a long time. Was there something that kind of pushed you over the edge into, like, actually doing it? Was it, like, a conversation or?
Yeah. Actually, with Sabrina, our communication social media lead, so she's a really good friend of mine. She's, like, one of my best friends. And also she works for me, like, part-time doing with photo stuff. So she just, like, kind of helps with admin and all of that for my photo work. So I was sitting down and I was talking to her about, we were probably just like running through a list of tasks or whatever. Mm-hmm. And I don't know why, but I felt kind of just compelled to bring up the idea to her and tell her, hey, this is something I've been thinking of and I really want to do it. And she's like the most supportive friend and like coworker, teammate, whatever in the world. So she's like, yeah, that's really cool. Let's do it. Like,
done.
You want to start a magazine?
When
rad.
Do we start?
Yeah. Nice. And I think the pressure of that, of having a conversation with someone that wasn't me or my husband was like, oh, this is
you
real.
You don't want to do it. Yeah. Because it makes it real. You're like, yeah. I want to make this magazine. And someone's right. like, yeah, let's do it.
And then I was like, oh, okay. Yeah.
That's great to hear. I mean, that was like, it's in the write-up, obviously. Go, you listener, you viewer, go read the magazine. Go pick up a copy.
Yeah.
It's out today, Visible, issue 3. And you can read our What the Podcast write-up, because that's a similar, like, start to basically this podcast. Mm-hmm. Is John spoke it at just like a, you know, mutual friends gathering. The Pinnings, actually. And
oh, it was the Pinnings.
We were at the Pinnings house and issue 2. Cat Binning.
True.
She's greatest.
No, yeah.
Good people in that
I totally get that, like, pressure of an idea and taking the first steps into bringing it into existence. And I think it's a lot of, like, your head has this image of, like, what you want it to be. Mm. And then there's this fear of, like, can it live up to that image or not? And then, it's, you know, every time it always exceeds it. You know, it's always like you get into it and it's more than you could have ever dreamed. You know, and I talk about that in the issue, you know, like when we started, it was like, so it was just like, yeah, it was just gonna be me and Ryan, you know? And then like now we're here at 78 with like a couch full of people, like just talking about everything under the sun, which is so much more than I think I could have ever had. So I totally get that.
Yeah.
So awesome though.
Yeah.
I'm glad that you did it though.
Thanks. Yeah, I'm glad you guys said yes to being in it.
I'm excited to see it.
Oh,
same.
I can't wait.
Here.
Every time I'm at their house, I'm always looking through the Visible magazine on the coffee table.
We do.
They're always out.
I'm always looking
That's
at
That's so cool.
Because there's something just show.
Where your word of mouth is our coffee table.
When, whenever people come over, they're like, what's this? We're like,
you gotta
what
check
is this?
You're like, Visible magazine.
Oh, I'll tell you.
There's something so like eye-catching about just the aesthetic of it. I know you put a lot of work into that. And
Thanks. So it's
a beautiful magazine. And
and
what I love about it is it's not like cheaply made. They're like, I liken it to like a photo book, like literally, like
that's cool.
You kind of go in there and you're like expecting you expect all this quality and it's just like met with great content. It's great.
It just feels good in your hands.
Yeah.
You know?
Oh yeah. I can't wait.
A
I'm
good
like
magazine.
Six copies of ours.
Come on.
I'm so excited.
It's so good.
Every guest that comes is going to get a Visible magazine. Issue 3, of course.
Oh, issue 3. Yeah.
She's like, you have to buy all this.
And I will.
You're like, we'll do. Dude, I kind of want to show you guys your... No.
Be kind of nuts. It'd be
I don't
kinda
know.
Cool if
unless
we saw it.
You can share it on the Apple TV. We just did that.
Whoa.
So
let's just get a brief look.
Wait,
because...
let me... You know what I'll do? I'll send you the gallery
that
we haven't sent to anyone yet. Okay. And I'll show you. You can throw
and
it
as
there.
And as we look at these photos, you can tell us how do you acquire one.
Like yes.
How can I see Visible Mag?
Because that's also a question I have is, how do I acquire one?
Because
right about now, everybody's thinking the same thing. They're like, oh, yeah, how can I get my hands on it? How can I get my eyes on
it? Just do what I do every time.
Go ahead.
Find Sammy on the day that it comes out. She has him in a car.
Literally.
You can find her
at
Moniker, probably.
Probably. I don't know. I love that that is literally what has happened both times.
Yeah.
It's so funny to me.
That is really funny. The day the first issue came out, we were like, oh, when's your magazine? You're like, today or tomorrow, I think.
Oh, try that again. Try that again.
Whoa. Oh, that's what we look like.
Look,
whoa.
This wouldn't be what the podcast without it.
Okay, so I'm wondering if I should just send you. Okay. I'm going to send you the link to this, which we'll have to scroll through because I think you guys are on page. There's a lot of pages, by the way. Page 69.
Nice. Did it go down?
There it is. Okay.
Oh, no.
She does understand. She does understand us.
She gets it.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay, so this is the PDF of the spreads, which will go to yours.
I'm
texting it in the group chat.
Oh, cool.
And then I'll also send the gallery link so you guys can look at all of those.
John, go ahead and open your text and then just put your text up on the screen.
Yeah, I will.
All of your texts. Yeah. Every single text.
Let's just read them real quick. Eh?
Whoa. Okay, hold on.
That's the cover.
Okay, are we seeing this right now?
Oh my gosh.
This is cool.
Oh my gosh.
Whoa. Episode 3. Season 3.
Okay.
Nice.
Don't give it all away.
You also can just scroll to 69. Oh,
69. Sorry.
69.
I was enjoying it. I got lost in it.
Oh, there's Ashley. Hey, Ashley. Yes.
You're almost there.
Okay.
Right there.
Whoa. Oh, my God.
Stop.
Oh, my God.
What a bunch of idiots.
They let us in a magazine.
I freaking love it. Wait, I'm in a videotape.
They let us out of our cage.
Yeah, look, that first picture is literally us running out of our cages.
Podcast first day out.
Whoa.
It looks great. Oh my God.
The single palm tree.
I know, your friend. Your palm tree friend.
Wow. There's us.
Here we are.
I still have the sunglasses that were
just
left.
Just the four of us.
Kara stole my gosh. Sunglasses.
You guys look so cool.
Oh my gosh.
Look at us. Oh my gosh, the one of me.
This dude really dragged his piano all the way up to the organ pavilion.
I freaking loved that.
And then turned it on and it was dead.
Okay, well, I got to get new batteries in this thing.
Oh my gosh.
Wow, this is a full spread. Oh my gosh.
There we are again. Just us.
I'm so ready to see
the OG. The OG two. There they are.
For some reason. Uh-huh. The two that made a really good first episode.
Wow.
Dang. Oh my gosh, this is awesome.
It is so cool.
Oh.
Aww.
My God.
Look at how cute we are.
You guys are so cute.
They are really cute.
Wow, we're walking. Dang. We're giving Vogue moments.
Oh my god! No freaking way!
She just walked.
Annie just walked in the door. Everybody,
come on in, Annie.
We're looking at the issue.
We're fully running. Fully running the episode here. Why are you whispering?
Cool?
We've made your presence known.
You're here.
Okay. Well,
she's whispering.
We're recording a Growing Pains episode after this.
Yes, she needs a space, actually.
Wow.
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited to see this.
I am too. Sammy, thank you so much. Tell us one more time, where can we find you?
Let me flip to our camera.
Yeah, cut to
John,
our camera.
John, do it for me.
Whoa!
Okay.
Under the chair.
I'm about ready to demote you as producer.
No.
You guys produce the show. Are we? It's fine. And the show's over.
No.
Psych.
Okay, I think that's the right one.
We're good?
Are we good?
Almost.
Can I go for it?
No.
No?
Are we?
Oh, no.
This is good. For those of you listening in your car, thank you.
There we go. It's on.
I know, for real.
And,
right.
We're back. Don't
worry,
people.
My name's Diesel, as you remember from last week.
Thank you so much, Diesel and John, for having me.
Little end of the episode thing I thought you'd throw in there, apparently.
Diesel.
Sammy, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having
Tell
me.
Tell us, where can we find you? Where can we find
Visible?
How can
Visible? We get a magazine? Yeah, I never...
Yes. Oh, okay, magazines are available. Physical copies are available for purchase at visiblemag.co. You can also read it for free digitally on the website as well. And then you can follow us at The Visible Mag or the podcast at The Visible Pod.
Wow. So exciting. We're going to link all that stuff below in the
and
old
then what
YouTube
is your,
bio.
What is your photography?
We sure will.
Oh, yeah, give us your Sammy handle. Noel is
at
my
Sammy Noel.
Photography page.
Wow. John's following you right now.
I am. Well, no, I was already following you.
Uh-huh. You guys, thanks so
He's
much for having me.
Thank you so much
so
for
fun.
Being here. Wow.
I'm a real fan.
What a time you are. And now you're part of the podcast canon now. So
oh
that's
true.
It's pretty exciting stuff.
Yeah.
I'm so excited.
John, any final thoughts?
Well, I will say this. I think this is really cool what you've done, what you've built here. And not a lot of people would put themselves out there like that. So I appreciate it. And from one creator to from all of us creators to you, like, we're proud of you.
You've taken, you took an idea. It was just an idea all those years ago, and you synthesized it. And now it's something we can look at, and we can read, and gosh darn it, that's cool.
Yep.
You guys are awesome.
Thank you for being on.
Thank you for having me again. Love this. Vibe in.
Mm-hmm. Well,
this is going to be really alienating.
Not much else to say, but
just hold on till the end.
Sammy, you want to do the outro for us? Do you know how it goes?
No.
We'll see you next week.
We'll see you next week
on What the Podcast!